So let me get an idea about what this poster is about.
Okay.
This man, the Swami, how do you pronounce his name?
Swami Satchidananda.
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 Was he connected to transcendental meditation?
Not directly, but both he and the Maharishi Mahesh Yogi, who was the leader of transcendental meditation, come out of a similar school of thought, and that Raja Yoga, which is a style of yoga that encompasses meditation, physical asanas, control of the breath, control of the senses, and goes back thousands of years in terms of discipline. Common origin, but they weren't associated.
So this Swami was coming to New York to do a presentation. How were you involved in this?
Well, actually, he wasn't coming to New York. He was returning to New York. He originally came to New York in 1966. He was invited to the city by Peter Max, as well as some others, initially just as a visitor, I believe. And during his time here, he started to give some talks and lectures on the practice of yoga. They started to attract a crowd of people who were interested. And sure enough, he started to develop some what would be called disciples or devotees. He started to teach and applied for a permanent residency visa at one point. So by the time this poster came into being for this event at Carnegie Hall, January 31st, 1969, Swami had been here more than 2 years. What he had done is, in the summer of 68, August 68, he left the country with about 25 of his disciples to tour India and what was then called Ceylon, now called Sri Lanka, in a tour of temples and other holy sites in India, and also to visit his ashram, which was in Sri Lanka. So having left in August, he was returning in January after this lengthy tour of the East. I was in charge of maintaining his school here in New York, which is called the Integral Yoga Institute. And one of my duties at that time was to organize an event soon after his return where he could give a lecture to the public. After getting rejected from many, many church auditoriums and other venues, including town hall, etc., I stumbled into Carnegie Hall and managed to rent that. And so he ended up giving a lecture at Carnegie Hall, which we called Swami Satchidananda in Concert.
Now the poster is expanding as it absorbs the wheat paste, so we are helping to stretch it out.
This poster was used to publicize the event. We printed several hundred of them. A couple of weeks before the lecture itself, which actually we called a concert, it was more than a lecture. There was some demonstration of yoga postures. There was some other visual effects. There was some music, and as well as the Swami's talk. A couple of weeks before this event, the poster was put up all over the city by groups of volunteers who went out in private vehicles with the posters and with buckets of wallpaper paste, and they posted them all over the city. The event was also publicized by leaving tickets at various locations. But in those days, it was felt that the people that would be most interested in this event were people who would be mostly associated with the countercultural movement at that time, which was the hippies. So many of the tickets were distributed to various head shops throughout the five boroughs, because we thought that would be an easy location and a known location for people to go and pick them up. But actually, as it turned out, the head shops did not sell that many tickets. A few days before the event, I went to pick them up in order to return them to the box office. And some of the shops had sold some tickets, But none of the shops actually returned any of the money from the tickets they sold because their business was sort of like hand to mouth, and every dollar that came in they had to keep. But it wasn't such a loss because the highest ticket price was $3. And in any case, the tickets got returned to the box office. There was some additional advertising of this event. We bought 6 one-minute advertisements on WNEW-FM radio for the week before the event. Some beautiful copy written by a great advertising man, Victor Zabel, was broadcast over the WNEW station. And lo and behold, on the night of the event, lobby at Carnegie Hall was packed and the event was sold out. And it was absolutely an amazing thing. Close to 3,000 people were there. And for the months afterwards, the Institute enjoyed a tremendous spurt of new energy, new student disciples, and got a great lift towards what over the decades has proved to be an incredible renaissance of yoga in America. And Swami Satchidananda was one of the key figures in creating that energy and bringing it forward.